Okay, the Turkish mini vlog. Oh. Take two. The Turkish mini vlog begins. No! Check me out. We in Turkey with the Jesus crown dreads. You see it. Things I anticipate doing in Istanbul,
already?
Turkey. I know we're gonna smoke mad hookah like we in the Bronx.
Oh yeah,
it's litty. They smoke hookah and they drink tea with it. And my grandma always makes tea for me in the mornings.
Thank you so much. We can get a Turkish bath right now. When in Turkey, get a Turkish bath. Okay. What's the name of this area?
Sultan Ahmed.
Do not ask me to repeat that. So, we're on our way to Ghana, but we had to stop in Turkey for a one-day layover. So we're here. We got here at about like 5:30. We're trying to set up to see if we could get some Turkish baths going, because like, why not get a Turkish bath in Turkey, right? So like, what else do we do in Turkey? We was thinking about getting some hookah, because that's what they do in Turkey. When in Rome, do Roman shit. And when in Turkey, do Turkish shit.
Yes. This is Halal himself. What's your name?
Fardi.
Yes. Fardi. My boy Fardi. We go way back.
Oh, it's going down. We're about to get this Turkish bath going, and it's super lit. To be honest, I don't even know what to expect. I know that I'm about to get bathed like a baby, and I haven't gotten bathed like a baby since I was a baby. Oh, so they gave us this, and they scrub us with this like thing. He puts his hand in here, and you okay? So pretty much, I have to change into this. Only this. So, let's do it. Like, wow. If you're ever in Turkey, okay, you must take a Turkish bath. It's like, man, after that long, damn near 10-hour flight, there was no better way to like settle my body into this very long week that we're about to have than a Turkish bath. Yes, there was some old man bathing me like I was a child, like he was my mother, but it was excellent, like amazing. Man, I cannot wait to see what else Turkey has in store for me. I think my favorite part about the Turkish bath was as he was like bathing me and like wiping all the dead skin off of my arms and my back and my neck and my legs, he's literally looking at me like, as if he's saying like, you dirty motherfucker. But it happens to everybody. Literally, white people, black people, Asian people, anybody that does it is going to get dead skin rubbed off of them. So that's like a thing. But he was literally, like, I know in his head he was like, this dirty motherfucker. I was most concerned with like them getting my hair wet because, to be honest, it's not that hot in Turkey. It's actually pretty cold. So I didn't want to get my hair wet. I didn't want to mess up the Jesus crown before I go to Africa. But yeah, they listened. They did not get it wet. Thank God. We out here, still in Turkey,
Yes, I got on my African sweater. That's pretty much where we're about to go when we leave Turkey right now, because we're on here on a layover. But I just wanted to come over here and show you guys that right there. That is the Blue Mosque. And I don't know if you guys ever heard of the Hagia Sophia, but that's right, that's the mosque that's right there as well. Beyonce! Beyonce! Yo, we've got compared to every black person in black people history. I'm Bob Marley, obviously, because I got dreads. Look, Beyonce. He's some black soccer player that they compared him to.
Abedule?
Abedule. His name is Abedule. That's the Turkey flag. It's crazy. I never know what a flag looks like until I actually visit the country. And then it stays in my brain forever. Watch when I go back to New York. I'm gonna see the Turkey flag all over the place.
Istanbul, it's like nearly twice.
It's nearly twice as many people in Istanbul as New York?
Check the Gucci.
I must say, it is not that hot in Turkey right now.
Yeah, we are waiting for snow.
Good old jacket. What's this area called?
Sultanahmet.
Sultanahmet?
And look, those places, they are all traditional Ottoman houses.
Traditional houses?
Yes.
Oh. So like, that's a house right there?
Yes. It's supposed to be wooden,
actually. Oh, they got wooden cribs up in here. Wooden cribs. All these cribs are wooden, but that's not that different to us, because I feel like when we go to the Caribbean, all my auntie's houses is wooden. No, not really. I'm lying. Oh, this is a high school. This is where you went to high school?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Right, babe?
That's right.
I see you with your Alexander McQueen's boy.
I see you. Sure, they fly out here in Turkey. Fly guy. A Rasta Bazaar. So it's a Rastaman's Bazaar.
How long has it been around?
More than 1,600 years.
More than 1,600 years. That's older than my grandma.
Used to be a horse stables in Roman Empire time.
Oh. So these all used to be horse stables, and they turned it into a big market. And if you look, like all this around these like arches, look like horse stables. He said these used to be horse stables, y'all.
For example, before we go to mosque, we take the ablution water. What is ablution water? We wash our hand, nose, mouth, head, neck, feet. Because of that, you need water. Like when you are sitting at home, you need water. What you do as a lady, so you pull all the water inside of this, and then you take one small piece like this. So you just give him the water and he washes his head.
My head?
Your hand, head, like everything, as a ablution water. But of course, if he's your husband, you do that. Boyfriend, no.
Boyfriend, it's okay. Because I'm not trying to get her to wet these edges. Because you know, they're still getting protected. Edges will not be released until we reach Ghana. That's when the edges is released. Hey. Boom. Literally everywhere we go, we can see the Blue Mosque. Like, it's almost like it's in the middle of the town or something. Because it actually might be. Like, literally everywhere. Oh, like, there's a bunch of rug shops. I could imagine that, like, the rug shops can't possibly make that much money because they're literally on every corner. At least seven. So that means you guys do a lot of vacuuming. Oh, wow. So pretty much he's saying that this yellow building is a five-star hotel, but it used to be a jail. In Turkey, they got like stray dogs, but like these is not regular sized dogs. This is a German Shepherd.
Them shits is well fed.
That shit is not malnourished. And that is the Blue Mosque. That's the building we just were at. That's the hotel we stayed at. Which is why we were able to see the Blue Mosque so easily. And now we're all the way at a different spot now. Yeah, so the coffee in Turkey represents 40-year friendship. So like whoever you have a cup of coffee with, you ask somebody out for a cup of coffee,
You're gonna be friends with them for about 40 years.
Shout out to Turkish Coffee.
Yeah. They are really big on the teas. They got lemon tea, pomegranate tea, pineapple tea.
This carpet. Apple tea.
What's the, like, economically, what is the best?
Apple tea.
To wrap our hair, we have to take off our shoes.
You don't have to.
Me?
The ladies have to.
Is there anything that guys have to do?
Just taking out their shoes off.
Just taking off our shoes. Uh-huh.
And your hand on your heart. That's the respect of the mosque.
Got it. So we have to keep our energy.
Otherwise it will open. Of course we
have. Yo, I went.
This is all on Lord. On the Lord first you make the line, which is the thread. On the line you make the knots. Means it is wool on wool. Okay?
What size? Like something like this takes 2 years.
Wool on cotton is more intricate. This carpet has.
How long does it take to make something like this?
10 square feet, like a year. Silk carpet has the label like diamond. Mm-hmm. Wool carpet like gold. And if it is woven, it's called kilim.
Kilim.
Kilim means it's woven. Silk and bamboo.
Oh. Yeah.
Look at the color, please.
Yeah, that's gorgeous.
You see the color?
What?
Oh, what the hell?
Mom, this scarf right here, that scarf ain't cheap.
His name is Dolce, my name is Gabbana.
Hey, Dolce and Gabbana.
Ya kere çok Johan'dan başka bir şey yemiyor oğlum, bu nedir ya?
Alright, he lost me. He lost me. We out?
Let's go falafel.
Bye. Falafel.
Bye.
Alright.
Thank you.
Alright.
Thank you.
He's a man. Alright, Istanbul. It was a great 24 hours. And now, next stop, Ghana.